Appearing before the Parliament's Committee of Trade, Tourism and Industry, Benson Byaruhanga, an economist and statistician at AGOA, called on MPs to ensure that the Ministry of Trade avails funds within its 2024-2025 national budget to facilitate the transition of the AGOA unit in Uganda. 1.7 billion shillings is needed for the process.
Estimates, but were not captured when I went and cross-checked with the policy unit. Reason being that AGOA is suspended. But one of the honorable members told us yesterday to the committee that it was terminated. So we are not appearing in the policy statement. We are not given money.
In December 2023, U.S. President Joe Biden took a financial decision to terminate the destinations of Uganda and other three sub-Saharan African countries as beneficiaries of the African Growth and Opportunity Act, over what they claimed was failure by Uganda to meet eligibility criteria. The AGOA office has been in disarray since. Committee members supported the need to facilitate a transition of this office that has been employing Ugandans instead of closing abruptly.
So how do we deal with this transition? In my view, they need some money to handle the transition. But it is a surprise that the government, especially from Minister of Trade, just keeps quiet and abandons it's people who have been operating the AGOA offices. So we need to handle, the minister needs to respond to this.
Alfred Edakasi, the Kabeda Maido County Member of Parliament, emphasized that there are still ongoing negotiations between Uganda and the U.S. government aimed at serving the AGOA market, which need to be funded by the government.
Efforts in that house this morning were that we needed to take an effort as government to engage the U.S. Congress and senators on the issue of AGOA. And the two gentlemen who were there gave us confidence that there is a possibility that this issue could be reversed. But for this issue to be reversed, it needed the engagement and lobbying Congress, the U.S. Congress, and members of Senate.
Some legislators asked the AGOA team in Uganda to explain why the country performed badly among the East African region and why the negotiation talks were led private individuals instead of government.
The ministry being at the forefront, then you hear of Ruabogo, you hear of Susan Muhwezi, and this is, and for me, partly to do with the management and why you are doing very badly. So I would want to know if we have to start giving money to AGOA on how then we deal with those challenges.
You say a transition to close, but there's no way we can appropriate in anticipation that maybe they will take us back. How?
Sure.
You can't say they will.
However, David Bahati, Minister of State for Industry, asked the committee to accord the Ministry of Trade more time to scrutinize the issue of AGOA and see how the transition and negotiations are financed and handled.
We are given a short time to rethink about this because, one, as Honorable Mushema has said, it's important, even if we are going to end AGOA, to do it in a smoothless way, therefore allow transition, because we have people who are employed there. We also have some residue work that we are doing. But also to understand that AGOA was specifically handling those items which were going into the American market.
The ministry also walked back on its earlier statements that Uganda is willing to forsake the United States market if it is tagged on support for homosexuality, and this time around saying the American market is still of importance to Ugandan traders. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.